Hello everyone, my name is Kleanthis Karamvasis. I'm from National Technical University of Athens. My topic is exploring driving factors of ground deformation using wavelet analysis. Ground deformation is hard to interpret and to use due to its complex nature. Ground deformation complexity is a result of coexisting driving factors which can be related to natural and anthropogenic processes. Our goal is to improve the interpretation and the usability of ground deformation from interferometric SAR signals via exploring the links with predefined driving deformation factors. The area of interest is located in northern Greece over an agricultural area nearby Kastoria Lake. The time of interest is from September 2016 till the end of 2019. The datasets consist of the ground deformation extracting using ICE and STAMPS PS functionalities and of five driving factors, which are temperature, soil moisture, precipitation, spatial variations of lake water, and NDVI dynamics. At the bottom left of the AOE, we can identify the subsidence zones denoted with a circle located at Mavrochori and Polycarpi villages. At this subsidence zone, and especially closer to the lake water, which is denoted with a white box, a clear seasonal behavior of ground deformation is observed. The linear subsidence rate of 1 cm per year seems to have significant impact on buildings according to our in-situ photographs. Next, clustering analysis of the ground deformation time series has been performed in order to reduce the volume of the data to be analyzed. The TSNE transformation, followed by an HDB scan clustering, yielded the presented results. In this slide, you can see the localization of the extracted clusters that from now on we will call regions. On the left-hand side, we can see the deformation time series of each region. Some of the regions appear to have stronger seasonal patterns than the others. The links between ground deformation and the considered driving factors were identified using a cross-wavelet transform analysis. It consists of two steps and the result is a 2D representation of the power and the phase between the two time series at time frequency space. As seen in the example image, the power is represented by the color and the phase related to the time lag by the arrows. We observe that the spatial variations of lake has an in-phase relationship with ground deformation at 1 year period. For regions 1, 3, and 5, no time lag was observed. For all the other regions, except region 8, we have a time lag of around 1.5 months. Regarding the precipitation, we can observe that for the majority of the regions, deformation and precipitation are in phase. We highlight that over the agricultural regions 3 and 5, no time lag was observed. For the majority of the regions, deformation and soil moisture are found in phase. For regions 3 and 5, no time lag was observed. However, for all the other regions, we have a time lag of about 1.5 months. Lake water variation, precipitation, and soil moisture can be considered as driving factors related to water cycle dynamics. We can conclude that over regions 3 and 5, ground deformation presented the highest agreement, in phase and with no time lags, with the water cycle dynamics. Next, deformation and NDVI have anti-phase relationship for all regions except regions 3 and 8 at a 6-month period. It is important to highlight that results at different time periods are contradictory, possible to different agricultural actions at field level. Finally, deformation and temperature appear to have an anti-phase relationship in most regions. For agricultural regions 3 and 5, a time lag of about 1 month was identified, possibly related to the crop calendar. The main conclusion of this study is that wavelet tools can reveal useful information between ground deformation and potential driving factors. We believe that wavelet tools is a suitable way to identify when and how much potential factors can be related to ground deformation. Moreover, we think that identifying driving factors is a critical step for modeling ground deformation with data-driven approaches. Thank you for your attention.